can't explain. So persuasive, I made some changes.
Hey guys, what's up? Today we have the Chasing Dory here. We're gonna do an unboxing and we're gonna see what's all inside this box here for the Chasing Dory. Now guys, go ahead and subscribe to my channel down here. I'm going to drop a video next week about how the Chasing Dory does in underwater. Now let's go ahead and take a look what's inside the box. So let's start with the drone itself. It comes in this nice hard black case with the Chasing Dory on the side. And if we open it, we're gonna see what's inside, and it's going to be the Chasing Dory. All right guys, so here it is. As you can tell, it is yellow and black. Black and yellow, black and yellow. Okay, so yes, this is the Chasing Dory. It's a really small underwater drone compared to the other products that they have, but it looks good, you know? Like, it's a nice design, it's cool. It's not kind of like ugly looking, so it's not bad for their product design. Let's go ahead and start with the specs of the drone. Like I said, it's black and yellow. And if you see this right here, this white thing right here is pretty much indicates that this is the top of the drone. Because when you turn it on, this is going to flash, so you know that your drone is facing the right way if this is on the top. So please don't put the drone like this when you put it on the water. You always have to put it and make sure that this is on the top. So guys, this weight of the drone is about 1.1 kilograms and the depth of the drone is 15 meters, which is around 49 feet. So it doesn't go really too deep, but it's good for lakes or like pools or anything that doesn't have to go too deep underwater. So let's go ahead and take a look at the front of the drone. Here you have two LED lights of color temperature of 3500 Kelvin to 5000. Now in the middle here you have your camera. The camera sensor is 1 to 2.9 inches with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 shooting at 30 frames per second. Also you have an f-stop of 1.6 and a focus range of 4 millimeters. Now let's take a look at pretty much the whole drone itself. Here you have five thrusters throughout the whole drone. You have two here, which are the same from the back. You have two here in the very back of the drone, and you have one right here. I'm not sure if you can see it, but you can see it through the light. There you go, you have your fifth one right here. So you have five thrusters in this Chasing Dory, and like I said, this will help you indicate that this is the top of the drone. Okay, now that's pretty much for the whole dory. Oh, I forgot to mention this right here in the back. This is where you're going to charge your dory, and I will explain that later with the charging adapter. Now let's go ahead and continue and see what else is inside the box. Here we have the Chasing Dory buoy. This is pretty much what's going to help connect your dory to the buoy, and this is going to help you control the dory with your cell phone. And you pretty much connect this to your cell phone using Wi-Fi. The connection length is 15 meters. So you gotta make sure that you don't go too far away from this buoy because this is your home base. Don't forget guys, 15 meters is the max length of this buoy to your phone Wi-Fi connection. One more thing about the buoy. This has a 16 gigabyte TF card inside. So it pretty much tells you how much you can have memory of recording here inside the buoy to your cell phone Wi-Fi connection. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the tether. This is a 15 meter tether, so this is going to help connect your buoy to your dory. Now make sure that you have enough space and slack so your underwater drone dory doesn't get lost. All right, so here you have your power cable. With this power cable, you have another cable that comes in the box. And I've noticed that this one, you connect here to this end, and this end over here, this is what's gonna go in the back of your dory right here. Something cool that Chasing did for the charger of your dory is that they included electrical adapters for your outlets in every country. So you have pretty much, I think this is North America. You have your Asia adapter. I'm sure this is Asia. Please correct me if I'm wrong. You have your European outlet, and pretty much that's it. You're settled to go ahead and take your Dory everywhere. You have your adapters, so you can go ahead and not have to worry about trying to buy one, because they pretty much hooked you up. Now on to this next little thing here. Chasing gave you a hook here, just in case you get anything stuck in the thrusters here. Remember, you have five of them, so just in case you get a rock or some seaweed, you have this right here, and you can go ahead and take whatever is stuck in your thruster, and you can take it out. So yo man, they're hooking you up. Also, something I got was a nice little towel from Chasing with the logo. I'm guessing this is to, you know, clean the doors, not for me. But it's pretty cool, you know. It's a nice little towel here that you have. And also, they gave me I believe this is some slack here. This slack, I guess I can tie it up to the buoy here and maybe hook it up to a pole, so I have some extra slack to play with. And this pretty much is like my safety, you know, just to make sure the buoy doesn't float away. I can tie this to the buoy and tie it to a pole or something around. So it's pretty cool to have something like this in your hands when you're outside using the dory. And also guys, the last thing I will talk about is this Chasing dory bag for you to store your dory and all your equipment whenever you want to go outside or on your trips, or if you're traveling, you have your dory bag. So no need to find a special bag for your underwater drone. Chasing provides that for you. Now guys, I will leave a link on the bottom of the description box. If you want to go ahead and purchase your own Chasing dory, you can go ahead and visit their website. Now guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace.